more quiet now. How you sleeping with the demon you're supposed to be casting out? So now when you get ready to cast that demon out, that demon will mock you. And that demon will look at you and say, are you talking to me? You were with me last night. How dare you try to cast me out when you slept with me last night? That's the reason why the church is weak. Sleeping with what we're supposed to be dealing with. We're sleeping with what we're supposed to be casting out. We're sleeping with, oh God, I wish I had two people in here. I need the intercessors to pray.
Oh, you want it.
He went down to Timnah,
right,
a Philistine city. And every time he went down, the Bible says he loved a Philistine woman.
Right.
It was singular. He loved a Philistine woman. Not women, a woman. And he went in and slept with her.
Right.
Every time he went in and he slept with her. And after he slept with her, he came out of her bedroom, came out of fornication, and he was shaking gates of cities.
Yes, he was.
When he got in last night, and you came and displayed the anointing. Came on Sunday and you were displaying anointing. Folk were falling out. Gates were moving, shaking cities. Oh, I ain't getting no help in here. You're quiet now. But you slept with a prostitute. You defied the vow. Oh, Raboshata. You're defiled because you defied the vow. You're a vow breaker. But when you stand before the congregation of the saints, you stand up as a man of God. You stand up as a woman of God. I'm after the spirit of Samson. To the body of Christ. I'm talking about being silent no more. Being silent no more. And he went in. And I just wanted to break this down. Because how do I know that there was no love for the people that he was supposed to deliver? Samson was supposed to deliver the Philistines. But instead of delivering the Philistines, woman of God, he went in and slept with the Philistine woman. After he slept with her, he turned away like he didn't know her. Like he didn't know him. And that's what we do to the people of God. We use them and then we look away like we don't know them. Oh Lord, oh God, I wish I had two people in here. I know it's getting messy up in here. It's getting messy up in here. It's going to get real messy. But I'm just talking about the Samson church. God wants to deliver us. God wants to set us free. God wants this plague to stop. This thing has got to stop in the body of Christ. The body was born in power. The body was born in authority. The body was born in array and splendor and majesty. The body was to be the bride of Christ, the very expression of God in the earth realm. What has happened to us? How did we get here? How did we get here? How did we get here? You'll sleep with the Philistine woman today and not know them tomorrow. And most time we give ourselves to a ministry but not to the people. Now that's the minister. Let me talk to the saints too. That spirit is on the saints as well. Because you give yourself to a ministry but not to the people. And Samson's generation will not participate in ministry unless they are at the center of attraction. An amen right there. Well, can you come and support my event? Well, am I going to do something? Do you have to do something to come and support me? Why can't you just come and support me? I ain't getting no help in here. We're the body of Christ. Every joint supplying. What's wrong with you just coming and sitting and just being a support? Why can't you just come and sit and pray? Why can't you just come and sit and intercede? Come on here, somebody. You don't have to preach. You don't have to be on the program. We're just supporting you for the kingdom. Jesus came preaching the kingdom of heaven. He preached the kingdom of his Father. But the reason why is because we are caught up in church and not kingdom. Oh, I'm talking about a spirit that I am dealing with this spirit. I am dealing with this spirit. I have dealt with it head on. I've dealt with it head on. But God has anointed me to deal with it. And he said, you're going to deal with it head on. When I hear people say, well, I can't go over there because she ain't put me on the program. Well, God didn't tell me to put you on the program. I didn't get an amen right there. And guess what? If you don't show up, praise God. When God says he's not showing up, I'll have a problem. As long as God shows up, that's good. Come on here, somebody. We need to get rid of this mess. Touch your neighbor, say, shut it down. Say it again like you got some power. Say, shut it down. Let me tell you, because the things of the kingdom are by the Spirit. You got to move by the Spirit. But when you don't have a devotional life, when you're not connected with God, you move by the flesh. And when you move by the flesh, it's about making your friends happy. It's not about making you happy. See, Jesus was so controversial, man of God, that you know, he's our pattern. He's our pattern. We pattern after Jesus. And Jesus was one of the people that offended more than anybody else. Jesus offended all the time. Ask me why. Why? Because he only did what he heard the Father say. And if you're doing what the Father is telling you to do, get ready to offend folk. See, I didn't get an amen. Touch your neighbor and say, come to the package. Or you better say, like you got some power, say, you come to the package. You know, you may be offended right now, but don't worry about it. By and by, you'll understand why. Come on here. Mary and Martha got so mad because Jesus didn't show up. And they said, you know, your friend Lazarus, whom you love. And you know, all that is manipulation. Who you love? I can't believe it. What you love? And Jesus said, I ain't coming. He said, I ain't coming. Why? Because I haven't got my marching orders yet. The Father said, don't go, so I'm not going. Then they came back and they said, you know what? He dead now. So what are you going to do? He said, how many days dead? And he says, oh, okay, I'm coming now. See, I didn't get an amen right there. And that's the same thing with church folk. Oh, I'm sick in the hospital. The pastor didn't come visit me. Amen. But do you know that the word can travel faster than the traffic? All I got to do is shut the word. Somebody just shut the word. Leave the church because I didn't visit you in the hospital. The devil is alive, but I prayed for you and I sent the word. The Bible says he sent his word and he delivered them. Oh God, all I gotta do is sit in my office and send the word. I cast the spirit of infirmity, I cast the spirit of affliction, I cast the virus, the bacteria, the infection, and I send the word. Jesus said to send the word. You got offended. I am coming to church no more because the bishop didn't come. He did not come to visit me. I ain't come. The devil is alive. Touch your neighbor and say, send the word, woman of God.
Oh, I know it's getting hot in here. I'm sweating so hard, Lord. I don't know what to do.